and I'm from an organisation based in Southampton called the Rose Road Association. And today, I'd like to share with you our process to becoming data protection compliant and cleansing our individual data, as well as sharing with you our outcomes and findings, which will hopefully be useful to anyone confused on where to start with the mazes data protection. So to begin with, why should you clean your data? We all know over the past year that the way that charities deal with data and their donors has become a contentious issue, and we've gained a lot of bad rep from that. So we need to keep it in the forefront of everything that we do with our donors. If you couple that with the fact that no matter the size of your organisation, data is the key to your fundraising strategy. You could have a great marketing plan, you could have the best team, the best events, but if your data isn't on point, you could easily fail, even though your intentions are great. If you think that 15% of people move houses each year, you can see how your data could quickly become out of date. So for us, we have a database of about 6,000 individuals, or we did have, and if 15% of those move, that's 900 pieces of data that are becoming out of date every year. So if you're a large organisation, say you have 600,000 individuals on your database, that's 90,000 pieces of data that are going to become out of date each year, and that you'll have a mess on your hands if you're not careful. We also need to focus on our donors. What do they want? How do they want to be contacted? And what do they want to hear from us? And the best way to do this is make sure that we have their preferences, that the donors are on our database, their data is correct, and we need to make sure that it's all on point. So, Rose Road, our decision. We had a database that hadn't been cleaned since 2004. So that meant about 15,000 pieces of data that had been added by fundraisers of the past. We didn't know if they had informed consent. We didn't know if they wanted to hear from us, or even if they knew who we were, or why they had been put on our database. We couldn't truly say that we had unambiguous consent. Our data capture forms weren't best practice, so any data we were acquiring was becoming a problem. And it wasn't being added in a way that was compliant with data protection. So that meant both our historical and newly acquired individual data were an issue for us. So we took on the big decision of contacting all of our individual donors on the database, but we took a different turn from most charities in that we decided, should they not respond to our communications, we would cease contact with them. So how did we do that? Well, as I said, we had an issue with historical and newly acquired donors. So we updated our data capture forms to make sure that they were in line with Data Protection Act, and we used a really helpful service from the ICO, which is their anonymous helpline. I would really recommend that. We segmented all of our donors that were on the database already. So if they had a personal address, did we have an email for them, how would we contact them, and what was the best way? We then created an online data return form. We really wanted to break down the barriers for our donors in getting back to us. We knew that unless they were incentivized and unless it was easy for them, we could easily lose them, and that's something we really didn't want to do. Then the long process of contacting people started. We had a member of staff that spent a day and a half a week contacting people on the phone, and we had some really great stories from people that upped their donations, that were really keen to get involved with Rose Road again, and what we did, and were really engaged. We then sent an email out to everybody else that we had an email address for, and then we had a great team of volunteers that posted letters out to the rest. And then the task came of updating our database, and after a period of time we decided, as we said, to cease contact with those that did not reply. So, what are our outcomes? We had a 15% retention rate, which might scare some of you somewhat. That breaks down to keeping 611 people. We had 149 return pieces of mail, so these were people that we were writing to, that were either deceased or they'd moved, and this had prompted those people that lived at the address to get back in contact with us. We had only 5 requests to be removed from the around 4,000 communications, and we had the big number of 3,091 people that didn't respond, so that looks something like this. So the silver lining, that might be all very scary for you, that we lost 85% of our individual donors, but I can truly say that it was the best decision that we ever made. We now have quantity over quality. You know, our donors, they're engaged with us, we know they want to hear from us. Then they know a bit more now about Rose Road, and it's easier to build relationships with those people. We're getting better communication responses from them, so we're not contacting 6,000 people that don't care about us and don't want to hear from us. So our marketing is becoming better. There's less resources expended in future mailings, so we're not contacting these people that don't really want to hear from us. Donations from those that appreciated the letter. We had some really lovely stories of some people that wrote back to us and said, you know, we really appreciate that you're taking our data so seriously in this climate, and we're really glad that you care about us. Here's a donation for all your effort, and we'll keep Rose Road in mind for future references. Our data is now clean, most importantly. It's compliant, and we've got a great base to make our strategic decisions from. And crucially, there's a fundraising preference service, the EU GDPR, which might not happen now, but we'll see what happens. We've got a great base to go from, and we feel in a great position should we should any future changes happen. So conclusions. We're only just starting to see the ripple effects. I can't tell you how it has affected our fundraising, but initially it doesn't seem to have had any adverse impact on our donations. In fact, the resources that we're spending on contacting those people that actually care and are engaged with Rose Road has really given us a great return on investment. It's enabled us to start again with the donor segmentation and the donor journey. As I said, we can focus so much on those donors that actually care about our work. And it was a scary task, it was a huge undertaking, but it's more than worth doing, and it's put us in a great position to implement any changes on future data protection regulations. And it's what we feel has put us on a great pathway to fundraising success.